Chapter 25. Ship. Elle sat on the floor, stunned. That was the best cookie they had ever eaten. They couldn't believe the flavors, the texture, the experience this cookie gave them. It was as if they were floating through the air. Wait a second. Elle looked down at the floor. It was very far away. Then they looked at their feet. They weren't touching the floor. In fact, Elle brought their feet so close to their face to look at them that they were now doing a backwards somersault through the air. Elle looked at Aunt Witch with widened eyes as they floated backwards in circles.
Oh my! Well, that wasn't supposed to happen!
She said, resting her chin in her hand and cocking her head to the side, staring straight back at Elle.
Another batch ruined!
She said, dropping the cookies to the ground. She walked over to the counter, grabbed the remainder of the dough, and dropped it to the floor with the cookies. The ants swarmed the dozen cookies and lump of dough, breaking them into chunks and heading out of the room in a single file line. The mess Aunt Witch made was cleaned up and spotless in no time. Elle was so preoccupied with watching the ants work that they forgot they were floating in the air. Aunt Thea was still perched on Elle's shoulder without a care in the world. In fact, she was giggling at Elle again. She was always happy to be home with the antics of Aunt Witch. She loved to go out on errands and adventures too, but home is where she enjoyed working the most. She never knew what Aunt Witch would get into, and every day was something new with her. She sat down and got comfortable for whatever it was Aunt Witch was going to cook up. Even she couldn't be sure.
Now, to take care of this little problem,
Aunt Witch said as she walked over to the closet in the kitchen and opened it up. There were all sorts of cookies, breads, pies, pastries, cakes, and who knows what else piled high on the shelves.
Here, a bite of this ought to do the trick,
she said, tossing a star-shaped donut with chocolate icing and sprinkles up at Elle. They caught it, barely, and bit off one of the 5 points, getting a bit of icing on their face. Elle felt something different, for sure, but they weren't dropping back down to Earth. They felt an itch on their back, and when they brought their hand around, they felt something soft. Elle grabbed it, but it felt like they were grabbing themselves, but it wasn't anything they had ever felt before. Elle turned around to look at the rear end. What was coming out from their pants was a tail. Elle screamed.
Oh my! Guess that wasn't right! Catch!
Aunt Witch said, this time throwing a pig-faced bun up at Elle. They caught it, but hesitated to bite. So far, everything they ate from Aunt Witch did more harm than good. But with no other option, they took a bite. Again, Elle felt funny when their ears grew long and pointed. Aunt Witch said, tossing baked good after baked good at Elle. Bunny-shaped, heart-shaped. Aunt Thea was sitting on Elle's shoulder, letting out a great fit of laughter every time something new happened to Elle. If Aunt Witch couldn't fix a simple problem she created on her own, how could Elle get back home? They were too concerned with getting home to laugh at everything that was happening. Elle hung there in defeat. Aunt Thea looked at them with a frown, then back at Aunt Witch.
Okay, okay,
she said as she started to dig through her cupboard, throwing ingredients onto the counter.
Let me whip something up for you. It's sure to cure,
she said, throwing an unknown amount of flour, sugar, and mystery ingredients from some vials on the shelves of the walls into a bowl and kneading them. She put the bread in the oven, grabbed the wand from her hip, and waved it at the oven. It jumped a few inches into the air with a puff of smoke, and a blue glowing light emitted from it. She waved the smoke away and brought out a perfectly baked loaf of bread in the shape of a ship and gently let it go towards Elle. It sailed up to them softly, and they plucked it from the air. Cautiously taking a bite from it, they suddenly felt heavy and started to slowly sink back down to Earth. Elle landed softly and couldn't have been more thankful to be safely on 2 feet again.
No,
Aunt Witch said, dusting the flour off of her clothes.
What is it, Anthea, brought you here for?